In this video, we're going to show you how to add a really cool masking transition. This is a zoom masking transition, and it can create some really unique transitions for your travel videos. Hey, I'm Mark Brown from Editor's Keys. Welcome again to the channel. And if you haven't been here before, consider subscribing and hitting that notification bell because we have a ton of tutorials all about filmmaking and editing. So make sure you subscribe. Now, in this video, we're going to show you a really cool and simple masking transition, which will take your transitions to a whole nother level. You may have seen this type of transition in a music video or some travel vlogs. So we're going to show you how to do it today. And I think you're really going to enjoy this. It's a great one to have up your sleeve. So let's jump into Premiere and I'll show you how it's done. Right, so for this transition, I'm going to be using this shot of an eye and then zoom into the eye directly into this other shot. So the first step is to get both of your clips onto the timeline and then line them up. Go to where the eye just starts to open and then move the second clip underneath at this point. Then go over to your opacity tool and select the ellipse tool and place it onto the eye. Then to reverse, come over to here and then click inverted. Now make sure these keyframes are enabled and go through each frame and line up the clip so that it follows the outline of the eye and stays in the same place. I'll fast forward through this bit to make it a bit faster. Now that's done, add a bit of feathering to make it look cleaner and blend nicely. Now, when you go back to the beginning of the clip, you may notice that there's a bit of black mask here. So to get rid of this, just cut the clip and then delete the mask from this section. Now, go to a few frames before the end of the first clip and go over to your effect, then toggle the scale keyframe. Have it around zero around here, and then go towards the end of the clip and scale it to about 500. And there you go. To make the transition smoother, add the directional blur effect and keyframe it towards the end. You can also add a whoosh sound effect to make the transitions more effective. Now, here's the final outcome with a light color grade and some added sound effects. So there we go, that's a really cool effect you can add to your videos today. And remember, you don't need to use an eye, of course, you can use anything. You can use a door, a window, a wheel, a lens, anything with a nice shape, it makes it a little bit easier. But let me know in the comment section, are you gonna use this now? I do get back to every single comment, and make sure you subscribe to the channel if you wanna learn more about filming and editing. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.